The road is long, with a many a winding tongue that leads us to who knows where.
Hello, friends. Just a couple of guys with your hosts, Pat Crimmins.
Good to be here.
And Ray Rogina, talking everything. And today we're at a location that I would call a testament to being its brother or sister's keeper, being a prime example of community benevolence, and another example of care and compassion, the Northern Illinois Food Bank in Geneva, Illinois. And Pat, it's not our first rodeo, if you will, to a non-for-profit, but a very important one.
Oh, sure. You know, yesterday was Martin Luther King's birthday, and of course he always preached, no pun, that we should do unto others, right?
That's exactly.
That's what they do here. It's very impressive. It's my first time here.
Yeah, it's a wonderful facility. I volunteered here before. We're gonna talk to you about doing the same. When we have a conversation with none other than Shannon Thompson, who's the director of volunteers here at the food bank. And she's gonna tell us a lot about volunteering and a little bit about the food bank itself. And then we're also gonna go down and see how the operation works downtown in the so-called warehouse here. So all of that.
And more.
And more. After a word from one of our fine sponsors. You stay tuned.
Tony, your parents know you're over here again, right?
Yep.
Great.
Tony lives next door. See, his parents decided to just use their phone for home internet. So when everyone is on, Tony's over here streaming
and drinking all my soda.
My dog.
Switch to fast internet on the Xfinity 10G network today. The future starts now.
We're going to bed, Tony.
Good night. I'll lock up if I leave.
Get real home internet on the next generation 10G network only from Xfinity.
Well, we're back and very pleased to have Ms. Shannon Thompson with us. And Shannon here is the Director of Volunteers at the Northern Illinois Food Bank. It's a real pleasure to have you here today.
Well, thank you. Thanks for joining us at the food bank.
Well, we think very highly of the food bank, not only yes. Pat and I, but I think I can say that about the Fox Valley. I mean, this is a gem here in Geneva, Illinois, and we're very, very happy to talk about it, perhaps get more volunteers, perhaps have a few more donations, and at the end of the day, just keep this a smooth running operation that is. Listen, let's get to start by just asking you a little bit about yourself, you and the Northern Illinois Food Bank. How long have you been here? You're Director of Volunteers. A little bit about you and the food bank.
Sure, yeah. I have been at the food bank almost 22 years. So I started when I was 12. And a little bit about me, right? Someone asked me at one point if I'd love to come be a volunteer coordinator at the food bank. So I checked it out, and at that time we didn't have a coordinator, and so volunteerism without having someone checking in with the volunteers kind of fell flat and started to drop. So that was back in 2001. And when I started, there were about 22 people on staff. We have over 180 on staff now. So it's kind of fun to see, not fun, but it's fun to see the people that join us, and including staff and volunteers and donors and things like that. But unfortunately, we're still in the business of trying to put ourselves out of business. But I've done a little bit of everything. I've done volunteer coordination and special events and food drive coordination and things like that.
That's a very interesting quote.
Yeah.
You're in the business to run yourself out of business.
It would be nice. If there were no hungry people, you know, right.
One more thing, and you told us offline, just a little bit personal. You're a North Central Cardinal.
My parents met at North Central.
Oh, we have that legacy. All right.
Yeah.
Pat.
So, just so the folks know, and we'll get to this later, but where exactly are we located?
Oh, we are in Geneva, Illinois, right now. This is our headquarters for Northern Illinois Food Bank. We have three other centers, a little bit smaller than this one. So I know we're going to take a little tour later. You'll get to see how large we are here. But we also have centers in Lake County, Rockford, and Joliet.
So describe those centers in relation to this food bank.
The easiest way is to explain what our capacity is volunteer-wise on a Saturday. So on a Saturday in Geneva, we can accept about 150 people. The other three centers, our caps are about 50.
Okay.
Yeah.
And the difference outside of size is what, if anything?
Number of people that work there. We have, probably more than 100 people, part-time and full-time, that work here. And at the center level, we might have from 4 to 10 people that work at the center. So
in terms of the volunteers, what is it that they actually do? Can you describe that for us?
Sure. It's a little bit different at our Rockford Center, and I'll talk about that one in a little bit. But here in Geneva, we sort and pack food. It'll be produce, canned goods, boxes, any kind of I guess non-perishable and perishable foods come in and out of the food bank here. Some of that is donated, and actually over the past couple of years, we've been purchasing a lot more because we've needed to do that to meet demand. So volunteers are packing those into different categories here.
Okay.
So, and then in our Rockford Center, we're actually serving, that's a food pantry now. It's called the Winnebago Community Market. So we're serving neighbors directly.
And just for the viewers who may not know, obviously there's a need. There's food insecurity, I guess, throughout the areas that you spoke of,
right,
where the food banks are located. So describe that a little bit for us.
Yeah, times are harder now, I think, than they even were pre-pandemic. So people are still struggling to make tough choices. So some are choosing between keeping the heat on or their lights on versus paying for food, paying for medical, things like that. And so we feel like a lot of those increases in the neighbors that are coming to our pantries are because of higher costs of food. I mean, all of us go grocery shopping, and we know that it's more expensive now than it has been in a long time. So so even though people are working, their wages can't keep up with what their
costs
of things are.
Do you serve other parts of the community in terms of need, like homeless, or now we have the migration problem?
Homeless, yes, we do have a lot more neighbors here. We probably have double the number of neighbors that are coming to our network of food pantries right now than we did even pre-pandemic.
Okay, and you describe them as neighbors?
Yeah, we describe them as neighbors,
okay.
Yes, because we're all neighbors, whether you are a donor, a volunteer, someone who's in need of food assistance.
Or whether you're homeless.
Or whether you're homeless, yep.
Okay.
The food bank here supplies, and for the audience here, who probably some of them that are listening to us or watching us know about food pantries, and they probably have donated to food pantries. But the fact is that this food bank, as well as other food banks around America, are the big kahuna for the food pantries.
Yep.
And supply the food pantries and stock much of what's in the food pantries.
Right.
You, as I looked at the notes here, you supply 900 different food pantries in and around suburban Chicago and rural northern Illinois.
Right.
That's a big area.
It is. Yeah, we have 13 counties that we serve with 900 food assistance sites in there, and we're distributing food to about 540,000 neighbors a month.
Wow.
And that's about 82 million meals annually. So
you're also part of this, at least there's 200 of them, food banks that are part of the Feeding America network.
Mm-hmm.
Across the whole country.
Yep.
Talk a bit about that.
Yeah, Northern Illinois Food Bank is one of 200 food banks across the country that are part of that Feeding America network. I always like to say that we're the best. We have the best volunteers. We have the best donors.
The best food.
But what we have in common is that we're doing the same things but in different service areas. So Feeding America connects us with donors. So we might get in touch with a donor that will give us a truck or money or volunteers or things like that. So they connect us to other resources in the community that can support us.
Just approximately, in our audience, mainly the Fox Valley and the DuPage County, what would you say the number of food pantries you supply just up and down the valley here? I mean, off the top of your head?
Off the top of my head, how about I look at my notes? That we have in DuPage County alone, I would say, there are 49 food pantries in DuPage County, and then 27 pantries in Kane County alone. So that's just two of our 13 counties.
I thought maybe you mentioned Chicago as well.
No, actually there's another food bank that takes care of Chicago.
Okay, that's what I was wondering, because you guys have to deliver to these pantries, and it didn't make any sense for you to go to Chicago.
Yes, we do.
And as long as you mentioned delivery, and as long as we're just warming up from a real bad cold snap, I take it the truck still got out, like the mail,
We were, I will tell you the quote that our director of transportation said today was, next week will be better, but yes, we were able to get trucks out this week to continue to distribute the food to people that need it. So. It's constant struggle, but he's always on top of it, making sure that things are working. Even when we're closed, he came in over the weekend to make sure things were working.
The good news is the food doesn't spoil in the cold.
That's right.
True. Yeah. The people might, though. It's really
that's
cold.
Self-made icebox outside. Right. Listen, we're going to take a small commercial break. When we return, Pat and I are going to talk to Shannon a lot more about the volunteer structure here and perhaps how you can get involved, whether it's monetarily or physically down in the warehouse. We'll take a break and we'll be right back. Stay tuned.
Hello, friends. This is Ray Rogina. You face technology challenges every day that threaten to steal business, compromise data, and bring your business down. Without a good partner to help protect from phishing, ransomware, viruses, data breaches, employee turnover, and cybersecurity threats, your business is at risk of losing everything. TechWorks has been the trusted IT partner to Fox Valley businesses for over 20 years, keeping systems secure and providing extraordinary customer service, helping your business grow. Call TechWorks today at 630-482-2227 or visit www.techworks.com. That's TechWorks with a Q. TEQ works, and see how TechWorks IT service can transform and secure your business.
All right, we're back, and we wanted to talk some more about the Illinois Food Bank and some specific questions. One of which is, how many volunteers do you have, like, per year? How many hours of volunteering do you have per year? Let's say 2023, for example.
Yeah, last year we had 20,000 unique volunteers support the food bank in many different opportunities, and that worked out to be about 137,000 hours.
Wow. So tell us a little bit more. If I want to volunteer, I have to be in somewhat good physical shape, I would think. But what am I actually going to be doing as I volunteer?
Well, first of all, I think you meet the age requirement. You have to be 8 or older.
Okay.
So yes, you can definitely volunteer with the food bank. And so basically, we have an online sign up. So we encourage people to sign up online. You can see our calendar of events, and you can see how many spots are still available and sign up that way. Working at the Geneva, the Joliet, and the Lake Forest centers, you have to be 8 or older. And that's mostly food packing and sorting. But at our Rockford Center, you do have to be 12 or older, as well as any outdoor distribution where you're distributing food to neighbors directly. You have to be 12 or older. So there's traffic that's involved with that. There's neighbors coming in to shop directly. And so we like children to be a little bit older and be chaperoned, obviously.
Yeah, obviously. I was going to say, if somebody's 9 years old, you want them chaperoned.
Yes,
right?
For sure.
When you have the volunteer questionnaire, What are you asking? What are you looking for?
Really, to sign up to volunteer, you just have to fill out some basic contact information. Definitely an email, because that is the way that we communicate with you. In this time of the year where the weather is bad, it's a good way to be able to let you know if we've had to adjust shifts because of the weather. So, but yeah, that's pretty much it. I mean, you know, email.
So
number,
then it goes through
name.
Some scheduler, and then they get back.
They choose online what shifts they want to come to,
okay. And
then they show up. So it's not like they're telling the volunteer team they're interested, and then we have to contact them back to make sure they're signed up and things like that.
Okay.
But our volunteer team, we've got about 7 people on the volunteer team here in Geneva, and we schedule the 20,000 volunteers every year. We will book larger groups. So if a corporation or a church or a school, civic organization, any kind of a group that wants to come in and volunteer, most of that can be done online alone, but if it's a group of 20 or more, then we ask that they give us a call, or they can fill out our team reservation request online, and then a volunteer coordinator will call them back, get them all set up.
My wife and I volunteered here for approximately 6 months on Thursdays. And it was really a fun and wonderful experience. And to your point about groups, it was fun to see on occasion, you'd walk into the room where the orientation took place and so on, and here's 12, 15, like you suggest, mm-hmm. all wearing the same shirt,
mm-hmm.
and they're either from a church or
right.
some civic organization, and you guys had it all down cold where you're saying, okay, St. Peter's, you're going over here,
right.
we're gonna, you're right. gonna handle this over here, and so on. So it's, well, we talked offline about this, but and Pat asked a question, I thought it was a very good question about those who may, because of a minor infraction or whatever in the criminal courts, have to do community service. And mm-hmm. So when that happens, you do have people come
we
over
do.
Here to,
somebody
to fulfill
on our
a community
team,
service
right?
requirement.
Right, somebody on our team coordinates our court compelled program, and very often someone might need to serve about 200 hours, and so they'll come on in and they do have to fill out an application and they get approved and
well,
come in and
Pat,
serve their hours.
I'd ask Pat this question. When the judge says 100 hours of community service, they give the person who's been charged or convicted now an opportunity to pick their community service?
That's correct. So you have an opportunity to go to Anderson Animal Shelter, all of these places, as long as you come back with proof from mm-hmm. a written letter with the letterhead and somebody signing off on it that they did their hours.
Definitely.
And here's the proof.
Yeah, and we have that available at all four of our centers as well.
Right.
So it's a great way for someone to serve hours that may need to. Certainly, we have heard from a lot of people that they prefer to come give back to an organization that is supporting the community. You know, if they've got to serve the hours anyway, why not pick an organization like Northern Illinois Food Bank to come on in?
Now, people sign up for a shift. Do you have, I remember we would come on Thursday mornings.
Right.
What are your standard shift times?
A little bit different across the centers, but typically we've got about 4 to 12 shifts per center, depending on which shift, you know, which center it is. The morning shifts are typically 9 to 11:30, afternoon 1 to 3:30. We do have a couple of evening shifts that run
okay,
from 5:30 to 7:30.
Very nice.
And then Saturday mornings, typically at every center, there's a shift.
Is there music fed at all times into the
Oh, of course.
Absolutely.
Of course.
Dancing is not allowed,
yes,
however.
Yes. And if you'd like to sing, we will get you a microphone and you can, no, I'm kidding.
That's
don't
right.
Do that.
Oh, okay. Pat likes to sing, so
right?
he could, at, while he's bagging the potatoes, he might start to
right.
sing.
We'll call
right.
the dance lady and maybe she can help us out with some
Oh, moments. I would like to hear more about that later.
Yeah.
Tell me about that.
Let's ask a very important question here, because besides volunteering, this is a non-for-profit. And of course, non-for-profits always, always accept and encourage monetary donations.
Right.
And you have, and I've been downstairs, they give a list of benefactors a mile long down there, people who have been
right.
very generous over the years. So if somebody wants to make they're watching this show and they say, I'm gonna drop a C-note or more to the Northern Illinois Food Bank, how do they go about it?
Basically, they can make a phone call or they can go online to solvehungertoday.org and make a donation. I mean, we typically can stretch your dollar a little bit here at the food bank. So if you donate a dollar, it helps us provide about $8 worth of groceries. Try doing that at your local grocery store for yourselves today. That would be a little harder to stretch that dollar. But we're really seeing a decline in donations since the pandemic. And are making every effort to continue to meet that ongoing need. And so if you are able to help, please do. Even if you volunteer, it's okay to donate as well. And a
Absolutely.
Lot of companies, and I don't know that everybody always knows this, but a lot of companies and corporations will match donations. So if you are someone that volunteers or makes a donation, a $25 donation or something like that, a lot of companies will match hours and time and money. So always ask your company that. You know, go to your HR team and ask, you know,
right.
do you match my donation?
Yeah. I like the fact that when you send out, you know, requests for a donation, a lot of times what will happen is you'll indicate on there your donation of $25, $50, $100 mm-hmm. will feed
mm-hmm.
these many families, these many people. And I think that's very important to put that in context. What is that $100, $500 donation doing as far as seeing that families who are less fortunate than you are have a chance to bring themselves back up to speed. So I like that a lot. SolveHungerToday.org. Get on that thing right now. You know, we're encouraging you. That was one of the reasons we came here today. We want more people here in the Valley and in DuPage County to understand the idiosyncrasies of this food bank and why it's so important for this suburban area we know as DuPage, Kane, and the greater Chicagoland area.
Right. And I think it's important to remember that even though it's, you know, not the pandemic anymore,
right,
we're still feeding so many people that we continue to need those
sure,
donations.
Because their lives have been affected by it.
Right.
Sure.
And I know everybody's lives are affected now with, you know, higher food costs and things like that. But we just want to encourage people, if they're, every little bit counts. So please, whatever you can donate.
If I may, there was some talk of shoppers. I thought you said something about that. Can you explain what that is?
I did, yes. At our Rockford Center, that is called the Winnebago Community Market, and that is our food pantry. And so our neighbors can come in and shop there. It's a little market, literally, where some of the volunteer shifts include volunteers stocking the shelves, making sure that they're filled with good, nutritious foods for people to choose from. And so the neighbors can come in and shop. And so I think it helps with that, you know, giving them dignity that they can come in and choose what they eat instead of us saying, here's your bag of groceries, this is what you'll have to eat the next.
So thank God I haven't had to go to a pantry for food to feed my family, but ordinarily you go to a pantry and here's a bag of stuff, right?
Yeah.
So this is different, right? Because you get to pick your own stuff.
But that's just Rockford now?
So that's the center in Rockford. It's,
are you
it's
thinking
a
about
pantry.
That in any of the other three locations?
Not at this time, no, but yeah.
Only reason I ask, I'd be the first one to volunteer, given my grocery background.
Oh, sure.
I'd love to volunteer in the grocery side of the
world. Right.
You know, I have a background.
That's good
as
to
well.
Know. We'll write that down.
I got in trouble for stuffing too much in a bag.
Yeah.
I was just trying to be generous. You know.
Right.
We're going to take a commercial break. And when we return, Shannon is going to take us downstairs. And we're going to see how this operation unfolds. And perhaps we'll talk to a volunteer or two.
Sounds good.
Stay tuned.
Hello friends, this is Ray Rogina. Are you looking for the place to be? Voted best live music and entertainment venue by the Daily Herald in 2023? That would be Old Republic in Elgin, an indoor-outdoor hub with classic American eats, beer, and cocktails, plus the best sports bar, burgers, wings, and ribs. Best value? Old Republic. Another good place to be.
All right, now we're right here again in a volunteer
hall
in the bread line, and we have one of the volunteers, in fact, a volunteer supervisor, Dawn. And Dawn, thanks for coming on with just a couple of guys. And I guess the opening question is, why do you volunteer at the Northern Illinois Food Bank?
I enjoy giving back to my community and helping others in need.
That's a very admirable comment. You know. You can't beat that.
No.
And if I may ask, how long have you been volunteering?
I started in 2020.
During the pandemic?
During the pandemic. I'm in real life, I'm a nurse. And
so you know
I was like, if I could be brave and go to work during the pandemic, I could come and help here. And then it turned out to be my social time during the pandemic.
Well, how many new friends have you met?
I have made several good friends.
The thing that they don't talk about as it relates to volunteerism. It's the social aspect. We here at the Food Mag encourage volunteers, thus the social aspect.
Is there any particular task here? There are many.
Right.
And I will tell you that my wife and I both have volunteered here and enjoyed it. But we're going to come back and do it some more. But my question is there any particular task here that you like more than others?
That I like.
All right,
let's
and this will give our audience a chance to know exactly what kind of task exists.
Well, one of my favorites is the produce.
Sure.
Dividing it up to small bags with the group.
See, I like this one a lot.
You know, so I like that one. But I do also like this MPX. get your steps in, so you get your exercise.
Matt, are you listening?
Here,
exercise?
Constantly moving. So those are my favorites, basically.
And if you had to just tell our audience, maybe in a capsule, why they should consider coming over here and joining the volunteer team, what would that be?
You come, you feel good about yourself after a shift. You get exercise, you have some lifting, which is good for everybody. Right. Doing a little lifting.
Get to leave the house
steps,
a little bit, huh?
Get out. Yeah. It is winter time. I don't know when this is going to go out, but winter time, it gets you out of the house. And again, it's like a social thing. You'll meet some very interesting, fun people.
How many hours would you say you volunteered in 2023?
Oh, in 2023. Oh, they usually round that up. I did more in 2020, but it was probably 250 hours.
Wow.
At least,
the podcast thanks you. Yeah, that's awesome.
Our new friend.
Yeah.
Dawn,
yeah.
The nurse here in the area, but volunteering at the NI Food Bank.
And a heck of a dish sucker, am I right?
Yeah, it is. Very good.
Isn't it? Joe stuck in the advertising.
We'll be right back. We're back here at the NI Food Bank with some closing comments. And Pat, some observations.
Wonderful experience. My first time here, of course, unlike you and your wife, but my first time, I enjoyed the experience. Is a wonderful place. Big, very big. A person like myself could volunteer here.
They're remodeling the front to make it a joyous entryway for people committed to volunteer.
And we talked about volunteering and donating, and one of my questions was how much of each dollar actually goes into the process and the donation. 96% of every dollar goes into the food product and the actual service, as opposed to administration.
It's nonprofit at its very best.
Yeah.
No question about it. And as someone who observed non-for-profits up and down the valley over the last number of years, they're at the top. They're right here at the top. They do a wonderful job here. And
how do you donate that money?
Well, first of all, Shannon, talk about volunteerism. You got a complete overview of that, so there's no reason why you shouldn't know how to come here and volunteer. The second piece, though, is the money. And I'm going to throw that challenge out to all of you right now and say that it's a worthy cause that you need to drop a few dimes their way to help this wonderful experience that they provide for people in need. That website, again, which allows you to volunteer or donate, solvehungertoday.org. Do it.
So there's urgency.
There's urgency.
Even though we would like to solve hunger tomorrow, it would work for us.
I still like Shannon's comment back here that she's working for a day when this place is out of business.
Right.
And that's just, to me, just that capsulizes everything. All right, so it's time to say goodbye. And so for, first of all, Shannon Thompson.
Of course.
And her friend and partner and a working personally well here directing a variety of things, Katie Herity.
Yes.
For our cinematographer,
videographer,
and publisher of Fox Valley Magazine.
Yes, it's a trivia question. People didn't know that.
Kevin Ketchum. For my partner, Pat Crimmins. Having fun today and learning a lot.
Yes.
Ray Rogina is saying, from the Northern Illinois Food Bank, stay warm. It's cold out there yet. So long, everyone.
Take care. He ain't heavy.